All right, coming up on 6:14 on this Tuesday morning, and today's the day we are going to see the biggest impacts from Tropical Storm Elsa. Right now, Elsa just over 100 miles away. This is the latest advisory from the National Hurricane Center. Now, the hurricane hunters are on a mission right now, and they're flying into the storm, and so they're going to get some real-time information here over the next 1 to 2 hours to see what kind of strengthening or weakening, if any, that we've seen here. But I will say that the forecast calls for this to gradually strengthen as it continues that motion parallel to our coast as we go through the next several hours and through the day today. So 2 o'clock through about 3, 5 o'clock this afternoon, that's when it's going to make its closest approach to Southwest Florida, staying off of our coast. We are not expecting to see a landfall here. Right now, that's kind of immaterial because the wet weather, the windy weather, is displaced on the eastern side. So this is not one of those classic textbook storms when you have really the strongest winds and all the rain right here packed a little more tightly to the center of circulation. This is going to scoop up, and already is, a lot of tropical moisture. And the NBC2 First Alert Live Doppler radar has a great vantage point from here in Southwest Florida. Notice most of us are dry right now, but this is what we can expect through the day today. If you have something that you absolutely need to get done outdoors, some errands to run, next couple hours will be the time to do that. But as we get closer to about 10 o'clock this morning and closer to lunchtime, and especially through the afternoon, all of this that you see here is going to be smack dab on top of Southwest Florida, and there's a potential for some severe weather with that. Now, I want to show you something else here as we track Tropical Storm Elsa. And to give you an idea of the path that it's taken, there's that northward bend as expected over the most narrow strip of Cuba. We're hoping it would spend more time there, help to disrupt it, weaken it, but we haven't seen any kind of rapid strengthening this morning. Those winds are holding right now at 60 miles per hour. But this is not the most impressive looking tropical storm. Notice how it's kind of elongated and stretched out. And as I pointed out a second ago, all the big thunderstorms and the heaviest of the rain, the strongest of the winds, are displaced to the eastern side. We're looking at some really strong consensus now with our forecast models with the track. So there's a very high confidence with as far as the track is concerned. You don't see any model plots taking it over to Southwest Florida. This storm will track very close to Tampa Bay and then eventually move up into the Big Bend of Florida. Now, here's something else that I know you're not used to seeing. You a lot of times see the spaghetti plots for the overall track. This is essentially what we're looking at, the spaghetti plots for the strength of the storm. So here's how it works. The area in green, this is tropical storm strength, and once you get up to the yellow, that's a Category 1 hurricane, and this is a Category 2 hurricane. So this is where we're at this moment in time. That's the current strength of the storm. Each one of these lines represents a different forecast model solution for the strength, how strong each model thinks the storm's going to get. The timeline we're interested in when it's going to be closer to us is basically, well, let's go back and see if I can do that here again, is basically this slice right through here. And you can see very strong consensus this will most likely be a tropical storm as it moves by Southwest Florida. So here's what you can expect as we go through the day, kind of visualizing when those rain bands start to move in. This is around 10:30, 11 o'clock this morning. And one of the things we'll be keeping a very close eye on, and we've talked about this, is the potential for an isolated tornado or two. We saw one tornado warning close to Clewiston. That was just before 4:30 this morning, and that tornado threat will increase just because of the wind shear in association with the tropical system. You have these quickly spiraling cells, and sometimes that could spawn a quick, brief tornado. 5 o'clock this afternoon, the rain continues along with those gusty winds, with Elsa passing just off of our coast. And there's something else I want to show you too. Even though Elsa will continue to move away from us closer to 10 o'clock tonight, we're going to have that onshore wind and the rain will likely continue. There's still a lot of moisture behind Elsa, so it's tropical tail, so to speak. It's going to linger all the way through about Wednesday morning. You can see 7 o'clock on Wednesday. We're still dealing with some of these tropical downpours. And I want to show you a couple different things. Number one, this is our in-house exclusive computer forecast model that updates every few hours. And these numbers are going to jump around. But I just want to show you, I think, worst case scenario in terms of rainfall, we could see several inches here, especially from Lee County, Cape Coral, up into Charlotte County. Might not be 12 inches, but I think on the range of about 4 to 6 inches, but there could be some pockets, some localized areas that see more than that. And so that's why we have those flood watches in place, and it will not take much rain up above 4 inches to lead to some localized flooding. You can see the path that Elsa's taking, but look where all the moisture is. Look where all the rain is here on that eastern side, especially over western Collier, up into Lee and Charlotte County. So rainfall amounts could be fairly substantial. Here's what I was trying to show you a second ago with the spaghetti plot showing the strength. If you remember that graphic, this is the time when it's going to move close to southwest Florida. And most of those model plots, pretty much all the model plots at that point, is in the green, which keeps it at a tropical storm strength. Here's a close-up view on southwest Florida's only live Doppler radar. That storm just to the west of Key West right now. And as we break down some of the impacts in terms of the wind, we'll get to those wind impacts here. Let me go ahead and see if I can pull that up for you just to show you how strong their winds are going to be through the day and when you can expect it to be strongest in your neighborhood. Notice the yellow. Those are the tropical storm force winds getting upwards of 50 and even up above 50 miles per hour with some of those wind gusts. And then the winds start to subside as we head through this evening and tonight. You can see them dropping down closer to 20 to 25 miles per hour. So it is going to be a rainy, windy day ahead. If you can, stay inside. It's maybe not a good idea to be outside today. You can keep it with us and we'll keep you updated every step of the way as we track Tropical Storm Elsa. And you can see those temperatures staying in the 70s today with cloudy skies, rain chances of 100%, and some of those tropical storm force winds possible, along with storm surge potential, which we'll talk more about that coming up in the next half hour.